So there are two ways, one of which is to turn down the heat, which we'll talk about later. But the one thing I want to talk about is venting. I think we have done a supremely bad job of teaching people how to manage their anger. And what we do is we tell them, take a cleansing breath, center yourself. Now, if you've ever been angry, you know that's the last thing you want to do is take a cleansing breath and center yourself. You want to break something. You want to throw something. And so I've thought a lot about this. What happens when you become angry is your body creates a cascade of chemistry. You know, your brain sets off the adrenal cortices. It shoots adrenaline into your bloodstream. It increases your blood sugar levels. You've got these chemicals running around your system called cortisol. You got increased endorphins. You're just jacked up, like you're on speed. I mean, you're angry and you're really, really hopped up. And so the last thing you want to do is go sit and reflect on your feelings. You want to go do something else. Venting typically is, I'm going to vent by yelling at you, which the research suggests only increases more anger. So I started to think, how do you then get rid of all this excess chemistry? Well, I thought, politically correct pepper. Yeah, I know, it's not a big sell. But okay, so you get this, here's politically correct pepper. It's an abbreviation, PCPEPA, PCPEPA, okay? Here's what it is. It's perfectly controlled, productive, explosive, physical activity. Let me say it again. Perfectly controlled, productive, explosive, physical activity. Here's how it works. When you're angry, I tell people, you need to be angry in a way that is perfectly controlled, productive, explosive, physical activity. And they go, oh, good, what's that? Now, I worked with a woman who said, you know, the way I deal with my anger is I go to garage sales. And I said, wow, that I think that'll work for me. And she says, and I go buy sets of dishes. And I said, uh-huh. And then I always keep a set of dishes that I bought in the trunk of the car. And I said, uh-huh. And so when I get angry, I just hop in the car, I drive out to the country, I open the trunk, and in the middle of the country somewhere on the road, I just smash all the dishes. I feel so much better. And I think to myself, well, like, what about the poor sucker who's driving up behind you? There's all this broken glass on the ground. I mean, he's going to get all his tires. She goes, I don't know. I feel so much better. And that's my anger management technique. And I'm thinking, gosh, that's a lot of work just to, I mean, and I always thought there's something wrong with this idea. Now, here's what's wrong with it. It's not perfectly controlled. It's not productive. It is explosive physical activity. Smashing china is always productive, explosive. It's always explosive physical activity, but it's not perfectly controlled and it's not productive. Now, people always say to me, well, I can't control my temper. Now, I used to work with people who were wall punchers, okay? Now, here's how wall punchers work. Is they get angry and they punch the wall. You know, oh, bam! Now, I was asked two questions. The first is, or three questions. The first question I ask is, how many times have you put a hole in the wall? And they go like, oh, I've been doing this for years. I don't know, a couple dozen. And I go, okay. And have you ever broken your hand? And they go, no. Well, I'll tell you, if you know anything about construction, studs are 16 inches on center, pre-finished 2 inches wide. So we'll just assume that there's a strip of wood an inch wide on average every 8 inches, or a 2-inch strip every 16 inches. I have a small hand. The width of my hand is about 4 inches across. So if I punch a wall 4 inches across, probabilistically, I've got probably about a 1 in 4 chance of hitting the stud. And over, I'd ask these men who are wall punchers, have you ever broken your hand? Because I guarantee you hit the wall on the stud full force, you will break your hand. And they go, uh-uh. And then I always ask the follow-up question, you ever get mad in the basement and punch the concrete? No. They never understand that. And so I ask him, I go, that's interesting that you never get so angry in the basement, maybe you should spend all your time there, that you would hit the concrete wall. and that when you hit the regular wall, you never hit the stud. I mean, it's amazing. So I tell them, you know, in these times when you lose control of your temper, which is a lie, you really are in control. Because when you're looking at the wall, you find the frame of the door and you go, stud. You find the light switch, you go, that's attached to a stud, and you're sizing it up. So from the point where you get angry, you go, safe, boom, you hit the wall. Okay, so when people say, oh, you know, I never broke, now if they've broken their hand, I go, well, you're either A, not too smart, or we need to practice this. But this tells me all the time, and people who get angry and they break things, it's amazing. It's always a cordless electric device, okay? Some sort of electronic. It's a pager, it's a cell phone, remote controls. The guy who invented replacement remote controls was a genius. Why? Because angry men all over the country, that stupid, cordless phone, same thing. Stupid, you know, I'm driving through a parking lot, I pull up, I park, I open the door, there's a smashed cell phone. And I'm thinking, I don't think anybody ran over it. I think somebody got mad and stomped on it. It's always a cordless device. Think, oh, I couldn't help myself. I go, liar, liar, pants on fire. You absolutely could. Because they never break something that's irreplaceable that belongs to them. Okay? They never find the thing that's a treasure of theirs and break it. If it's an irreplaceable object, it's usually belonging to the person they're mad at. Okay? What does this tell us? This tells us that this explosive anger is already being controlled. They're deciding where to hit the wall. They're deciding what kind of wall to hit. They're deciding what to break. So they already have control. The lie, I lost my temper, I couldn't help myself, is a lie. Because throughout this, all this evidence is showing they are exerting control over the way they express the anger. So I tell people, you want to become a master of your anger, you need to be a master by becoming perfectly controlled in your productive, explosive physical activity. My favorite example of perfectly controlled, productive, explosive physical activity is chopping wood. You get angry, you go out to a stack of wood with an axe, and I guarantee you by the end of that stack of wood, you will be exhausted. You will have used up all of your energy. But every time you chop that wood, you better be perfectly controlled. You can't be throwing a temper with an axe. I'm so mad. Or you can't just be slashing and hacking or what? You're going to cut off your toe. So there's a self-protection here. So what I tell people is if you become angry, you must find some perfectly controlled, productive, explosive physical activity. And people go, well, I don't have a wood-burning fireplace. I don't have an axe. I don't have wood. Fine. Get a fireplace, get wood. No. What I tell people is then find another thing. And I tell people, if you're a golfer, you go to the range and you hit a bucket of balls. And they go, oh, that'd be so good. And I'm going to crank these. And I say, no. It has to be perfectly controlled. If you're going to hit that bucket of balls, you have to hit for accuracy. You have to hit for a certain spot, not just go wailing at it. Because what you're doing is you're disciplining your anger. There's a great quote on anger that Aristotle said, and I'll see if I can get it as best as I can. He said, to become angry is easy. To become angry in the right way, to the right degree, for the right purpose, at the right time, at the right purpose, this is not easy. And if I look at the times I've been angry in my life, where I've done it to the right purpose, to the right degree, the Aristotelian way of becoming angry, maybe six times in my entire life. I've been angry six times today. Most of them are not in a controlled way. Okay? So what I'm telling you is it's very difficult to perfectly control the expression of your anger. It's very easy to be angry. But I hope I've given you evidence that you can control your anger and you do control it. So find a perfectly controlled, productive. At the end of chopping the wood, you have a stack of chopped wood. You've done something good. At the end of hitting the bucket of balls, you've become a better golfer. If you buy old dishes, there's nothing productive. You've just broken a bunch of stuff. A temper tantrum is not productive. Breaking things is not productive. Becoming better at something. So I tell people, they go, well, what's a good example? Okay, go running. Every footfall is a productive, explosive physical activity. Okay? And I assume running is perfectly controlled unless you run around crazy. If you are a baseball player and you go to the batting cages, every time you hit the ball and increase your proficiency at hitting the ball, that's perfectly controlled, productive, explosive physical activity. You can find these. And a lot of people go, well, I don't play sports. Okay? Do you clean your house? Vacuuming is the perfectly controlled. I mean, every time you move that, provided you don't hit, you know, swing the vacuum around and hit the furniture. Or, my favorite is, you really want to get your mat out, okay? You go scrub the bathtub. By the end, I mean, a really good scrub in the bathtub. Again, that motion of scrubbing will wear you out, and it's perfectly controlled, it's productive. At the end, you got a clean bathroom. Or you've got a vacuumed house, or whatever it is. At the end, some good has come of it. Most of us don't want to use that kind of discipline. We just want to throw a grown-up temper tantrum. But if you want to become angry correctly, you must become angry in a perfectly controlled way, so that at the end, there is something productive and good. The physiological result is you use up all the excess chemistry that your anger has created. And at the end, you're tired, and you're able to think more clearly. When you're activated because of anger, you cannot think clearly. So work out your anger in a productive way.